Howdy, Immortalium here, and welcome to another manga haul! Yay! I think I may have done that in the last manga haul. It's been so long that I can't honestly remember if I did the yay thing, but whatever. So let's get right to it. So first of all, as usual, I'm going to start off with the series I've been continuing on before I get to the new stuff. So first up is a series that I've been meaning to get back to for a while. I've just been waiting for a few more volumes to get out, so I'll be able to have a meatier chunk of it. And that is Attack on Titan. I got volumes 13, volumes 14, and volume 15. 15 being a very recent release. Basically, my policy with this is, you know, wait until about 3 volumes comes out and then pick it up. Because I just find it a lot more satisfying, you know, to pick up a volume, read it, then the next day to pick up another volume, read it, and just have a larger experience, I guess I should say, rather than just simply, you know, getting one volume and then just having it be more of a tease than anything else. You know, I just find that really annoying. So, anyway, the only other thing I want to say, I want to ask as well, is I remember Hajime Isayama, he said something about Attack on Titan and 20 volumes, and I cannot for the life of me remember did he mean like the whole series is going to end at 20 volumes? Or did he mean that there were going to be another 20 volumes before it ended? So like if any of you can actually answer that question, I would really appreciate it because, you know, if it is just 20 volumes in total, it's going to be like I'm 3/4 of the way through. If it's another 20 volumes, then there's still a long way to go. So I'm just kind of curious on that. But I think I tried to look it up recently and I failed. Anyway, next series is Ranma Half. Basically, these are 2 2-in-1, so it's basically 4 volumes. And of course, I don't need to tell you what I'm thinking of Ranma Half. I'm really enjoying it. I've seen like some videos from some people online that have told me that, well, people at least, they have told people that they're not enjoying Ranma Half. And that's kind of strange. I mean, it's a really, really charming series, nice artwork, likeable characters, very funny gags. It's very different from, you know, like the whole action-packed shonen stuff, so maybe that's part of it. But just to tell you, I'm having a blast with this series. I've only read the first 8 volumes, of course, and there's 38 in total, so, and I've heard that, like, the last part of the series isn't that great. It's just kind of a bit too, repetitive. But I'm still really enjoying the series, and I'm really, really looking forward to reading these. And after that, let me just check if there's anything else I've been continuing. Yes, there is. 2 more things, actually. First of all, let's start off with I got volumes 6 and 7 of the omnibuses of Lone Wolf and Cub. Now, I can hear a couple of you kind of suddenly asking, hang on, Immortalium, last we saw that you only had 4 omnibuses, and now you're getting 6 and 7? What happened to Omnibus 5? Where is that? Interesting story about that. A friend of mine, basically, we tell each other what we're going to get each other on at Christmas, just so that there's no mistakes. I got her the 2nd Omnibus of Tokyo Babylon, and she got me the 5th Omnibus of Lone Wolf and Cub. The interesting thing is I gave her my Tokyo Babylon Omnibus 2, but so far she has yet to give me Lone Wolf and Cub Omnibus 5. Now, I know she has it. She's told me so. And she just keeps forgetting it. She's been very busy, so it's kind of understandable. And I haven't been down to her house, so it's not like I can head down to her house and say, yo, could you go up and get me my Omnibus Lone Wolf and Cub? So anyway, I decided, oh, I'll get 6 and 7. And then once I get 5, yeah, I'll be like 3 fat Omnibuses of Lone Wolf and Cub to read, which will be wonderful. Also, it's a bit hard to tell how far I am in the series, because these aren't like full volumes, as such as that. What I mean by that, okay, like, that's very badly phrased. What I mean by that is this contains like part of a volume, a whole of another volume, and then part of another volume. So they're not, it's essentially like, I guess, maybe a bit more than a 2-in-1, which makes it a bit awkward to try to figure out how far I am in the series. But the point is that this will be, yeah, collect some material from volume 17 in this omnibus. There are 28 volumes in total, so I will be over halfway through once I get to this volume, which is great, you know, because one thing that I will say that is kind of annoying me slightly is Dark Horse have begun releasing these new Lone Wolf and Cub books, That look really nice. I saw it in a bookstore the other day, and they look really nice. They're unflopped. The artwork looks exactly like Koseki Kojima's. Problem is, it's a sequel to Lone Wolf and Cub, so I can't read it until I've actually finished the entire Lone Wolf and Cub. Of course, the other advantage is that by the time I do finish Lone Wolf and Cub, there'll be like 7, 8 or whatever volumes of new Lone Wolf and Cub out, and I'll be like, yes, I can just get a whole bunch of them and just read them through. So, you know, that'll be awesome once I get to it. And the only other one that I've been continuing on so far from this haul is Nana. I got volumes 11 and volume 12 of Nana. As I just said in my shoujo video, this is one of my favorite shoujos. It is so, so good. One thing I should probably point out about this haul is the euro has gotten a bit weak recently, so I had to pay a little more for a lot of these items, which means that this haul is a bit smaller. I originally wanted to get 4 more volumes of Nana. That's how I usually do it, but when I like had put in everything into my list and had to pare everything down, I just decided to get 2 volumes of Nana. Plus, Nana's on hiatus, so it's not like I need to rush at it, you know. It's still probably going to be 21 volumes by the time I get near the end, so. Or is it 23? Oh, I always get mixed up. Is it 21 or 23? I don't know. But point is, I really like a Nana. I don't need to rush it through, so I've got the next 2 volumes. And there was someone who was like, isn't it a Jose? It says so on Wikipedia. The all-time best-selling shoujo manga in Japan. You know, that says it's a shoujo. And I know there's a couple of other things, but I just wanted to point that out. Anyway, on to the new stuff now. So what new series has Immortalium begun to add to his collection? Let us start off with the most impressive one. This is kind of nice because it complements The Lone Wolf and Cub. And that is, I really, really want to read more of Kazuo Koike's stuff. Some of them are pretty hard to get now, like Lady Snowblood has gone out of print. A lot of Crying Freeman's gone out of print, which is really annoying. But Dark Horse recently did a omnibus re-release of Samurai Executioner. So this is actually all of Samurai Executioner, making it the first complete Kazuo Koike that I've gotten, which is completely epic. And these are fat, fat books. I mean, like, this is Omnibus 1. Take a look how fat it is in comparison to a normal Lone Wolf and Cub. It's a giant monster. Do you see that? It's like an extra, like, 100 or 200 pages. So, crazy stuff. But I'm really, really looking forward to reading this. I've heard from people that Samurai Executioner isn't as good as Lone Wolf and Cub, but it's still considered to be an excellent, excellent series. So I'm really, really looking forward to it. And I'm really hoping that the fact that Dark Horse did a omnibus release, re-release, I should say, of Samurai Executioner means they might do some omnibus re-releases of other Kazuo Koike stuff that they have. You know, like Path of the Assassin, Lady Snowblood, Crying Freeman, etc., etc. The best way to guarantee that that'll happen is to simply pick up the omnibuses, you know? Dark Horse want to... One sec. Oh, one of my... Okay, okay. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, yeah. God damn it, they keep falling. Oh, never mind. Anyway, just buy the omnibuses. Dark Horse want to make money, and they will probably do re-releases of the other stuff. The most likely thing they'll do next, I'd say, is Path of the Assassin, I would say. That being also done by Koseki Kojima. But anyway, beyond that now, what other series? From Vertical, I got the complete Limit. So Limit is a series that I've been hearing a lot about. Basically, it's actually a shoujo, but as far as I can tell, there isn't actually that much romance in it. It's about these girls who they're trapped somewhere, I know, after a bus accident. I don't know much more than that, but I've heard lots and lots of comparisons to is it Lord of the Flies? Lord of the Flies, I think that's the one, you know, the one where all the kids get trapped on the island. I read that book, but I'm not sure if I have the correct title in my head. Anyway, and also I've heard a couple of comparisons to Battle Royale. It is Lord of the Flies, it says so on the back. Not sure about Headers, that's another one they mentioned on the back. But anyway, I've also heard comparisons of this to Battle Royale. Now, I know that for sure that it's closer to Lord of the Flies than it is to Battle Royale, but I still really, really want to read this work. I mean, I've heard really, really, really good things about it. And also, they come in very odd packaging from Vertigo. Like, I mean, this is kind of strange. Vertigo, quite often they release stuff very big, or at least the stuff I've been picking up. But these are like quite small. They're smaller than regular Tankobon. Not only that, they're insanely light. I mean, the paper quality looks good, but I do know for sure from just feeling these paper that it is thinner than normal paper. I don't see any obvious page bleeding, so at least that isn't an issue. But these are like very, very light. I can imagine, you know, like just slipping this into a pocket somewhere and just pulling out when I need to read something while I'm waiting. You know. Anyway. So I'm really, really looking forward to reading this, and it'll be another nice thing to add to the collection of Vertigo stuff, particularly the shoujo aspect. My shoujo Vertigo collection is entirely composed of Princess Knight and Twin Knights. Not that there's anything wrong with that, it just would be nice to expand it. Okay, after that, let's keep up with the Vertigo stuff actually first. Tropic of the Sea by Satoshi Kon. Of course, I love Satoshi Kon. I've watched. Tokyo Godfathers, absolutely love. Paprika is really, really good movie as well. Millennium Actress, I thought was a good movie. I wasn't quite as keen on Millennium Actress as Tokyo Godfathers and Paprika, but I still really, really liked it. I've yet to see Perfect Blue. I've yet to see Paranoia Agent. I actually have Paranoia Agent, and Perfect Blue, Anime Limited just re-released, I should say, recently in a kind of a standard edition, like pretty cheap. So I really want to pick that up. Because then I'll have like all the anime that Satoshi Kon actually worked on. Anyway, that's besides the point. We're talking about Tropic of the Sea. Before he went into anime, Satoshi Kon did a lot of manga. And interestingly, when I opened this up to take a look at it, I was really surprised with the artwork. Because you know what? I opened it up and immediately I thought to myself, wow, that really looks like Akira. And I looked up Satoshi Kon then. Turns out he was an assistant artist for Katsuhiro Otomo while he was working on Akira, the manga, like. So it makes perfect sense that the art in Tropic of the Sea, which he did, I think around the same time as he was working with Katsuhiro Otomo on Akira, would look very much like Katsuhiro Otomo's artwork. Not that there's anything wrong with that, of course. Katsuhiro Otomo's artwork looks really nice, and Satoshi Kon's here looks really nice as well. Just, it isn't quite what I expect, I should say. The Satoshi Kon films have a very distinct look. But anyway, I want to read this, and it's a very short manga as well. It's like literally 200 pages. So I'll be able to read that and just, you know, be able to get an idea about Satoshi Kon's early works. And keeping on the Satoshi Kon path, I actually picked up Opus. Now, Opus is, I think it's considered the last big manga work that, what's his name? That Satoshi Kon worked on before he went into the anime field. Because of that, the art in Opus looks a lot closer to what his movies would look like than Tropic of the Sea did. You can really tell, just comparing the artwork in Tropic of the Sea to Opus, that Satoshi Kon's really finding his art style. Also, I must say that the story sounds really awesome to me. Like the idea of a manga artist working, he's finishing off a very popular manga series. He kills off one of the characters, and that character like pulls him into the work and threatens him and all that. It sounds really, really funky, but really, really cool. And the other thing to point out is Satoshi Kon actually didn't finish this work before he died. He went on a hiatus, and he died, unfortunately, while he was working on anime. And then, like, they were going through his desks or something afterwards, and they found, like, a storyboard chapter, like, what Satoshi Kon was working on for, like, a finale. And they actually did include it, like, Dark Horse included it. So, as you can see there, it's all, like, storyboards. But, you know, all the dialogue is there, the story's there. So, even if the art is a bit less, it's more basic, of course, because it's simply storyboards, we will actually get a finale to it, which is very nice. So, I really want to thank Dark Horse and thank, who was the publisher who found that storyboard, actually? One second. Serialized by Gacken. Gacken, I guess it must have been. Never heard. Oh no, Ryu Comics Editorial Department. Those are the ones. I've never heard of Ryu Comics, I must say. But I really want to thank them for being able to do this. And also, it's a really nice looking edition. It actually has some color pages at the beginning, which is really nice. So, just want to point that out. I'm really looking forward to reading this. After that, we're gonna go on. I think I have two more vertical series. Let's start off with this one. So this one is a bit, well, I don't know. I guess in comparison to everything else, I'm not quite as excited about reading this one now. It is Velveteena Mandala. And I bought this for one reason, and one reason only. And that was, it was serialized in Manga Erotics F in Japan. Now, for those of you who are unfamiliar with Manga Erotics F, first of all, the manga magazine isn't actually that erotic. It makes it kind of think pornography or something, the title. But it isn't actually. It's just weird, unusual works that wouldn't usually get published in other magazines. And they did a lot of stuff. I mean, Utsubora is from that magazine. What's that one? Lychee Light Club. I haven't read that one, but that's from that magazine. And Vertical are releasing Inio Asano work that was serialized in that soon. But the point is, the manga magazine's actually gone now. Unfortunately, there wasn't enough demand for it, so they had to shut down. And I really think that's a big loss for the manga industry. Because in my mind, a sign that an industry is doing well isn't that they're being able to sell lots and lots of books like One Piece and Attack on Titan and all that. It's that you're able to go in with weird and unusual works and experimental stuff and actually have the possibility of being able to have a success and to be able to make a career out of that. That's my kind of idea of a successful industry. So to see an experimental manga magazine go, it's very sad. And I know there was this other one, was Garo, and of course Simon Tezuka did his experimental magazine, Calm, which didn't last that long. So actually, that's another question I'd like to ask you guys. What experimental manga magazines are there left? I mean, those three are the ones that I really know, and besides that, like, they're all gone now. So I'm just kind of wondering, is there any manga magazine left in Japan that specializes in, you know, alternative strange manga? Anyway, that's besides the point now, I guess. About Velveteena Mandala. So basically, I bought it because it was serialized in Manga Erotics F. And then I actually did some research, and I know usually I do research first and then I order, but I had heard good things about this and, you know, serialized and that, so I just bought it. And then afterwards I started researching it and I was kind of going a bit, I'm not sure about it. Particularly the thing that worries me most is I've heard that there's a lot to do with feces in this. And that kind of got me kind of wondering. Not only that, I've heard that among the more experimental stuff Vertical has done, like released, this is among their weaker stuff, so that is kind of disappointing. But I guess it's still experimental manga, and you know, that means that I'll want to give it a go, and it'll definitely help to broaden my horizon or whatever. After that, my final vertical thing, and this I want to talk about for a bit, is I got the complete series of Prophecy. Now, first of all, I want to say I heard amazing things about this manga. Like, I don't recall hearing anything, like any bad reviews of this. Like, every single review of Prophecy that I've come across has been positive, like really positive. So that's gotten my hopes up. Also, they're making a live action movie of it soon. Hopefully that'll get a release at some point over here. Who knows though. But the two things I want to talk about is, for one, the author of this, Tetsuya Tsutsui. Oh god, that's, her name is very tough to pronounce. Tsutsui. Oh, okay, that's not too hard. Tetsuya Tsutsui. He actually approached Vertical to get this released in English. I believe this was published by Shueisha in Japan. And, you know, Vertical aren't allowed to license from Shueisha because Shueisha has a large share in Viz. So Viz basically get all the Shueisha stuff. But apparently that doesn't apply if the mangaka actually approaches the licensing company. And Tetsuya Tsutsui came over to Vertical. He said, like, you know, I really want you to be able to release this. And they did. And I'm thinking, God, that's really proactive of the mangaka. So, like, that's something that should be rewarded. The fact that the mangaka, who's so busy, like, mangakas don't really have that much free time. And yet he chose to spend that free time actually wanting to get this released in another language. So, I think, for one, that definitely deserves, you know, some kudos, I should say. And the other thing I want to point out is from Vertical's case. Vertical recently, they've... But done a bit of a logo change, I should say. The logo that that most people will be familiar with for vertical is the kind of line down vertical. Not sure if you can see that there. Sometimes they'll actually do like a secondary line, like that one up there, where the vertical is, you know, horizontal actually, and then there's like a vertical line. Basically, vertical in reality are actually specialized in releasing novels, like translations of Japanese novels. I think they said their most successful one was actually The Ring, you know, the novel that the movies are based off of, you know, The Ring movies. But anyway, point is they specialize in that. But as you all know, I would say by now, the manga section for vertical has expanded dramatically. Like, you know, when most people think of vertical now, they think manga. So Vertical really wanted to try to kind of re-establish their novel section. They want to kind of separate the manga section from their novel section. And because of that, they've actually made a new imprint now. And you see at the very top there, VC, or Vertical Comics. So that's for any new series now, they're going to implement that. For any series that has the old logo, like the Gundam Origins, or what else? Probably Knights of Sidonia. I don't have any of that, but that's from Vertical. They're going to keep the old logo so it isn't, you know, clashing. Because a lot of manga fans really find it annoying when, you know, the logo changes on the spine. But for any new series now, they're going to put in the VC. So I'm very happy that my first series with the new logo is Prophecy. And that is complete as well. I can just read the whole thing now. So like, I'm really, really, really looking forward to checking this out. It sounds absolutely fascinating. And then finally, I have two other series left. Two series that aren't complete, I should say. There will be stuff that I'll need to get started on. One is something that both of these I've been really wanting to do for a long time. Okay, let's start off with this one. This I really, really want to start for a long, long time. That is A Bride Story. By Kaoru Mori. I've heard insanely good things about this. Also, I love the presentation. This is a hardback from Yen Press, and it just looks absolutely gorgeous. So I really, really wanted to read this. Not only that, I've heard that the story itself is really, really good. That it kind of starts out episodic, you know, kind of almost slice of life set in like 19th century Central Asia. And then as the series goes on, it kind of steadily becomes more and more kind of an overall story. But it's absolutely amazing. And apparently it won like this big prestigious manga award last year. Was the last year or the year before? Very recently, I should say. Which is impressive because this actually started in 2009. So, you know, it's getting much, much more recognized recently, which has given me a lot of hope that it's one of those series that continues to improve. And, you know, doesn't suffer from, you know, a spiral down in quality later, as so many manga series have. So I bought the first two volumes of it. I believe just 6 volumes released in English. So I decided that in the unlikely event that I don't like the series, it'll just be 2 volumes. But I think I'll definitely be able to get a feel for this series from 2 volumes and be able to decide whether I want to continue it or not. I'm sure I will want to continue it, though, because from what I've heard, it sounds really, really good. And finally, the final thing, this is something I want to have been reading for years. It's only got a reprint recently. For a long, 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 long time, Viz have kept it out of print, which is a shame because I've heard a lot better things about this than the other work from the author. And I guess I'll just point out now, and that is, it is Dr. Slump from Akira Toriyama, as in the guy who created Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z. Although it was all Dragon Ball in Japan, except for the TV series, whatever. Dr. Slump. So basically, Dr. Slump is the series that Akira Toriyama became famous for before Dragon Ball. It is a very, very odd series. Like, it's pure comedy. And basically, there's this inventor who, he creates a robot, this girl being the robot, called Arale. And she is very strange. Like, she wants to understand stuff, but sometimes she's really, really awkward about the way she wants to understand stuff. And this series, I've heard, is very crude, lewd, rude, but hilarious. So I really, really wanted to try that out. Particularly, something that made me become even more hungry for this series is, you know, I've seen the first season of Dragon Ball Z, and I must admit, I was not taken to it. It just didn't do much for me. Now, I've watched the first two box sets of Dragon Ball, the original series, and I'm enjoying it. I'm really liking the comedy aspects, and I can see that Akira Toriyama has a lot more talent in terms of comedy than he does for, you know, actually setting action sequences and everything. You know, he's very skilled and talented at being able to make people laugh. So I've just really want to try a series that is 100% aimed at comedy. It's not meant to be action-y, it's not meant to be dramatic or anything, it's just comedy. So yeah, that's what I really wanted to try. And the other thing I want to point out as well is that the art is very different in general from Dragon Ball, which is surprising because there's only like a 5-year gap or whatever between them. 5-6 years? I don't know. 2 years from the end of Dr. Slump to the beginning of Dragon Ball, I know that. But the art is really different. Now, I think the art that he chose for Dr. Slump is a lot better for comedy than Dragon Ball would be. Like, one could tell that the more detailed artwork of Dragon Ball is meant to be action-y, a bit more dramatic, etc., etc. I just really want to try this out, and I'll see. There's 18 volumes in total, so I got the first two, and I'll be able to decide from these first two whether I want to continue it on or not. It won't be that hard to finish off. The whole thing's been released, and I think the whole thing has been reprinted, so I should be able to get my hands on them relatively easy now. But this is something I've been wanting to try for years, I would say. I also ordered a couple of light novels just to, you know, keep growing my light novel collection. It's pretty slow increasing, I will say, my light novel collection, but it is steadily growing. So what stuff did I pick up? First of all, I picked up volume 3 of Spice and Wolf. You know, as you know, I really do enjoy Spice and Wolf. I think it's a very entertaining series and very enjoyable. I love the chemistry between the two lead characters. So, you know, being able to continue on with Spice and Wolf is a no-brainer. And not only that, you know, the anime finished off on a cliffhanger, and there's no sign of another anime season coming, which is a shame. So the light novel is the way to go. After that, I also got another, the hardback. So, you know, another, the anime, basically I saw 5 episodes of that at the Anime Society. And they, basically the first 5 episodes, pretty entertaining, you know, I enjoyed it. Nothing amazing, but then I did a bit of research afterwards and I found out that the another novel is meant to be the best. You know, better than the manga, better than the anime, such that you just go back to the source novel where it all started. So I really wanted to check this out. And actually something that really annoyed me for a long time was exclusive to digital. Basically, Yen Press licensed another a long while ago, but they only released it digitally, and that annoyed the hell out of me because I'm not much of a digital person myself, at least in terms of manga. So I was kind of like, oh, I really want, you know, an actual book release of it. But unfortunately, it doesn't look like they're ever going to do it. And then all of a sudden, you know, Yen Press announced Yen On. And they started releasing a bunch of stuff. And one of the things they mentioned was another. And I was like, yes, I really want to read that. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to checking out another. I've heard really good things about the novel. And I've seen a bit of the anime, as I said, and it's pretty interesting looking. So, yeah, I'll be looking forward to checking all this out. As you can, well, it's a little bit smaller than what I'd usually get, and I would put that entire blame on the euro change. You know, like, everything was a bit pricier than it would usually be, simply because the euro is weaker than the pound now, so, which I find really annoying, because, you know, as you know, I'm very much a bargain hunter, and to be able, like, to be forced to have to pay higher prices, it's just very uncomfortable. But overall, I'm very happy with this haul. There's a lot of great stuff in here. You know, a lot of new completed series, which I'm really happy, like Prophecy, Tropical of the Sea, Opus, Samurai Executioner, etc., etc. Some new series I'm starting, Dr. Slump, Bride Story, and some series that I'm continuing on, Ranma Half, Attack on Titan, Nana, etc., etc. So I think overall it's a great mix, and I'm really looking forward to checking all this stuff out. So yeah, I want to hear what you think of the series that I picked up, and and the other thing I guess I should point out is that I actually ordered all this, just in case you didn't know, I ordered all the stuff before I uploaded that first contest video thing. So And none of the recommendations recommended to me during that contest had any impact on all of this. A couple of things actually, like I heard Prophecy and Opus was recommended to me, which is great. You know, like I was kind of like, oh yay, I already ordered them. And people were recommending to me. But so essentially the next manga haul is probably where you're going to see some of those recommendations start creeping. But for the moment, like no effect on this, I'll say. So thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and you're entertained and you learn about some new series, etc. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, and bye-bye.